rats in the attic, so you better go get some traps.
Rats?
Uh-huh. Afraid so.
But it's clean.
All right, then. We've got clean rats.
No, no, no rats. No.
I just heard them, Carl.
Must be the plumbing.
Yeah. Or maybe rats. Why don't you just go and get those traps?
Yes, I'll go now.
Oh, don't go now, Carl. The stores aren't open yet.
I'll go see.
They're closed.
Can you decide where to run off again? Get without it.
Burke, take a look at this damn thing. It just doesn't make any sense.
What? It's perfectly plain. You're the teacher at the college. You don't want the building torn down.
Oh, come on. You can read, for Christ's sake.
What's wrong?
Well, why are they tearing the building down?
Shall we summon the rider? Isn't Paris, I believe.
Hiding?
Fuck it!
Scene 39. Hotel. Take 4.
Betcha! Hasn't there been enough killing?
Mom, you should have seen. This guy came along with this beautiful
beautiful gray horse. Wasn't it pretty?
Was it a mare or a gelding?
I think it was a gelding. It was gray. Oh, it was so beautiful. And the guy let me ride it all round.
You're kidding.
Oh, for only half an hour.
Oh, I loved it so much. When can we have a horse?
Oh, not while we're in Washington.
Oh.
But we'll see when we get home, okay?
When can I have one?
We'll see, Raven.
Now, about the party.
Reagan. Get back here. Come on, give it up. Up now. You'll be sorry.
Thank you.
playing with it?
Yeah.
You know how?
Here, I'll show you.
Wait a minute, you need two.
No, you don't. I do it all the time.
Oh, yeah? Well, let's both play. Don't tell me there's no answer. Is the Hotel Excel Lucia in Rome. Try it again, please, and let it ring. Yes? Oh, operator, I've given you the number 4 times. What did you do? Taking a literacy test to get this job, for Christ's sake? Don't tell me to come, goddammit! I've been on this fucking line for 20 minutes!
Speaks up her leg. We take her out, team. 2 or 3
months, and she's as good as new. Sir?
Yes?
We want to see Mrs. Harris.
Do you have an appointment?
Yes.
Are you a relative?
Yes, I am her brother. He's the son.
Just a minute.
You know, it's funny. If you wanted a priest, you'd be a famous psychiatrist now on Park Avenue. Your mother, she's been living in a penthouse instead of here. Go in, Debbie. I'll wait for you outside.
You'll find Mrs. Harris on the last bed, on the left-hand side.
Seems to work to relieve the condition, but you don't exactly know how or why. Frank, your daughter's symptoms could be an overreaction to depression. That's out of my field.
Depression?
Well, you mentioned her father, and he was.
So do you think I should take her to see a psychiatrist?
No. I'd wait and see what happens to the Ritalin first. I think that's the answer. I'd wait 2 or 3 weeks.
And what about those lies she's been telling? Yeah, you know, like,
saying
her bed shakes and stuff.
Have you ever known your daughter swear and use obscenities?
Never.
Well, that's quite similar to things like her lying. It's
uncouth. Wait a minute. What are you talking about?
Well, she let loose quite a string while I was examining her.
You're kidding. Like what?
Well, specifically, Mrs. McNeil, she advised me. to give my fingers away from a goddamn cut.
She used those words.
She used those words. Look, I doubt if she even understood what she was saying.
Yeah, I guess maybe not. But you still don't think the psychiatrist...
The best explanation is always a simple one. Let's wait. Let's wait and see. In the meantime, try not to worry.
Don't stop. Keep going.
That's right.
Come on.
Understand how her whole personality could change.
The temporal lobe is common. may last days or even weeks. It isn't rare to find destructive or even criminal behavior.
Do me a favor, will ya? Tell me something good.
Don't be alarmed. If it's a lesion, in a way she's fortunate. All we have to do is to remove the scar.
Thank you. Abnormal strength, accelerated motor performance. Here's an example. A 90-pound woman sees her child pinned by the wheel of a truck, runs out, and lifts the wheel half a foot off the ground. Same thing here. Same principle, I mean.
So what's wrong with her?
We still think it's a temporal lobe.
What are you talking about? Did you see her or not? She was acting like she was fucking up her mind, psychotic or split personality!
There hasn't been more than 100 authenticated cases of so-called split personality, Mrs. McLean. I know the temptation is to lean towards psychiatry. However, any reasonable psychiatrist would exhaust the somatic possibilities first.
So what's next? No, of course not. Nothing like that.
Are you sure?
Of course I'm sure. Christ, I tell ya, I don't even smoke grass.
We'll be home soon. L.A. aren't
you? No. I'm getting a new house built. The old one got sold. I was going to take Reagan to Europe for a few weeks after she finished school here. Why'd you ask?
I think it's time to start looking for a psychiatrist.
Hi, Chuck. Come on in.
I suppose you've heard.
Heard what?
You haven't heard. Burke's dead.
He must have been drunk. He fell down
from the top of the stairs right outside and
by the time it is answered, he broke his neck.
Oh God!
Yeah, I know. Familiar with how sweet he died?
Only what I read in the papers.
Papers?
Tell me, what do you know about the subject of witchcraft? From the witching end, not the hunting.
I once did a paper on it.
Really?
From the psychiatric end.
I know. I read it. These desecrations in the church, you think they have anything to do with witchcraft?
Maybe some rituals using black mass. Maybe.
And Dennis, you read how he died?
Yeah. The fall.
Let me tell you how, Father. And please, confidential. Brooke Dennis, good father, was found at the bottom of those steps leading to Elm Street, with his head turned completely around, facing backwards.
Could it have happened on the fall?
It's possible. Possible, however.
The light.
Exactly. So on the one hand, we've got a witchcraft type of murder and a black mass style of desecration in the church.
You think the killer and the desecrator are the same?
Maybe somebody crazy. Somebody with a spite against the church. Some unconscious rebellion, perhaps.
Sick priest, is that it?
Oh, look, Farber, this is hard for you. Please, wait for the priest on the campus here. You're the psychiatrist. You'd know who was sick at the time, who wasn't. I mean, this kind of sickness, you'd know that.
I don't know anyone who fits that description.
Ah, doctor's ethics. If you knew, you wouldn't tell, huh?
No, I probably wouldn't.
Not to bother you, trivial, but a psychiatrist in sunny California was thrown in jail for not telling a judge what he knew about a patient.
Is that a threat?
No, I mentioned it only in passing.
Incidentally, I only mentioned in passing that I could tell the judge it was a matter of confession.
Hey, Father, you like movies?
Very much.
I get passes to the best shows in town. Mrs. Cable, she gets Clive and never likes to go.
That's too bad.
Yeah. I hate to go alone. You know, I like to talk film, discuss the critique. Do you want to see a film with me? I got passes to the crest. It's a fellow.
Who's in it?
Who's in it? Debbie Reynolds, Desdemona. And Othello, Groucho Marx. You happy?
I've seen it.
One less time. Can you think of some priest that fits the bill?
Come on.
Answer the question, Father Paranoia.
All right. You know what I think really did it?
Who?
The Dominicans. Go pick up.
I could have you deported, you know that. I lied! You look like Sal Mineo.
Have you ever heard of exorcism?
It's a stylized ritual.
in which rabbis or priests try to drive out the so-called invading spirit. It's pretty much discarded these days, except by Catholics, who keep it in the closet as a sort of embarrassment. It's purely the force of suggestion. The victim's belief in possession helped force it. And in just the same way, his belief in the power of exorcism can make it disappear.
So you're telling me that I should take my daughter to a witch doctor? Is that it?
Chance in a thousand. My hunch, my opinion, I believe he was killed by a very powerful man, point one, and the fracturing of the skull, point two, plus the various other things I've mentioned, would make it very probable. Probable, not certain, that the deceased was killed and then pushed from your daughter's window. But no one was here except your daughter. So how could this be? It could be one way. If someone came calling between the time Miss Spencer left and the time you returned.
The servants. They are visitors?
No, nothing like that.
We're expecting a delivery that day.
Not that I know of.
Groceries, maybe a package.
I really wouldn't know. You see, Carl takes care of all of that.
Oh, I see.
Do you want to ask him?
Never mind.
Would you like some coffee?
Please.
Sharon! Coffee!
That's Kira. Your daughter? She's the artist? Incidentally, got your chance in a million. I know about your daughter, but could you possibly ask if she saw Mr. Daniels in her room that night?
Look, you really wouldn't have any reason to be up there in the first place.
I know that. But if a certain British doctor never asked, what's this fungus? We wouldn't deny a penicillin, correct?
Well, when she's well enough, I'll ask.
Couldn't hurt. In the meantime, I hate to ask this, but for my daughter, could you maybe give an autograph?
Of course. You got a pet?
Oh. She'd love it.
What's her name?
I lied. It's for me. The spelling is on the back. Candyman. You know that film you made called Angel? I saw that 6 times.
Really? Wow.
You're a very nice lady.
You're a nice man.
Thank you. Thanks. I'll come back.
Thank you.
on the cars.
Sorry, Father. Hi.
Okay. I told you I wouldn't be in uniform.
Yeah, who the hell? So, how did Shrink ever get to be a priest?
The other way around. Society sent me to med school.
Where?
Harvard, Bellevue, John Hopkins.
You're friends with Father Guy, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Pretty close?
Pretty close.
He told you about my party.
Sure did.
About my daughter?
No. I didn't know you had.
He didn't mention.
No.
He didn't tell you of what she did.
You didn't mention.
Priests keep pretty tight mouths, then.
Hey.
What?
Priest.
What if someone was a criminal? Let's say, like, a murderer. And they came to you for help. Did you have to turn them in?
They came to me for spiritual help. I'd say no.
You wouldn't.
No, I wouldn't. But I tried to persuade them to turn themselves in.
And, how would somebody go about getting an exorcism?
I beg your pardon?
If someone was possessed by a demon of some kind, how would they go about getting an exorcism?
Well, the first thing I'd do, put them into a time machine and send them back to the 16th century.
I don't get you.
Well, it just doesn't happen anymore.
Oh, yeah, since when?
Since we learned about the mental illness, the paranoia, schizophrenia, all the things they told me in Harvard. Mrs. McNeil, since the day I joined the Jesuits, I have never met one priest who's performed an exorcism. Not one.
Well, it just so happens that someone very close to me is probably possessed and needs an exorcism. Father Karen's my little girl.
That's all the more reason to forget about an exorcism.
Why? I don't understand.
To begin with, it can make things worse.
How?
Well, before the church approves an exorcism, it conducts an investigation to see if it's warranted. That takes time. In the meantime...
You could do it yourself.
I can't. I need the church approval, and that's frankly rarely given.
Did you just see her?
I could see her. I could see her as a psychiatrist.
She's not a psychiatrist! She needs a priest! I've already seen every fucking psychiatrist in the world and they stick to you! And now you're sending me back to them? Jesus Christ! Will somebody help her?
You don't understand. Your daughter.
Just help her! Please help her!
Let's introduce ourselves. I'm Damien Karras.
Am I the devil? Now buy the rest of these scraps!
You're the devil. Why not make the straps disappear?
That's much of a logo display of power, Karras!
Where's Reagan? Show me Reagan. I'll use one of the scraps.
Your mother's in here with us.
That's true. Then you must know my mother's maiden name. What is it?
And the mystery of faith.
got joy.
What no for me yet?
Not you! Get me done dead!
How long are you planning to stay, Greg?
Until she wraps the lies taking in earth! What's that?
Holy water.
Yes? You haven't come.
Chris!
I'll be right there.
Important. It's the
avoid conversation with a demon. Chaos watch is relevant, but anything beyond that is dangerous. He's a liar. The demon is a liar. He will lie to confuse us. He will also mix lies with the truth to attack us. The attack is psychological, Dave, and also powerful.
Helpful to give some background on the different personality traits of manifesto. So far, it seems to be great. She's committed.
There's only one.
Thank you.
Ourselves as animal and ugly. To reject the possibility that Christ could ever love us. Will you excuse me, Dave?
going.
Sell ball.
I've seen it.
Oh. Another one. Had your lunch?
No.
I'm reminded of a line in the film Casablanca. At the end, Humphrey Bogart says to Claude Rains, "Louis, I think this is gonna be the beginning of a beautiful friendship."
You know, you look a lot like Bogart.
You notice?